Hi, hello, welcome to LRC. We are live. How's everybody doing out there?
The people slowly joining, emerging from the dark corners of the internet to join us on what is the most, what is a good way to describe
the,
like, what's the vibe of this month?
Anger, fear, trepidatious.
Fear, sure, trepidation.
Yeah,
agreed. Do we have we officially started? Is it, are we on, or do we wait until Steph arrives, who's running a little late?
She should be here soon, BT Dubs.
I mean, it's up to you. It's, if you think we should wait. I will admit, though, and I should have said this prior to you, your light side is real bright.
Okay.
And you're bouncing hardcore.
Oh, wow, yeah.
That's my bad. I should have said something before we started. I apologize.
That's fixable.
I didn't realize what it looked like on stream.
Why is nobody looking at me? My blue light is like incredibly precarious. I haven't quite secured it yet.
Does it perhaps randomly turn on and off?
No, I've mostly been gone since last week, so I don't really
because of Victor?
Yeah, because of Victor. Name. Why Victor?
I believe someone said a joke about something named Victor, or you, no, was it Jordan or Steph brought up a random name in the chat that with no context, and I was like, is that Anthony's ghost? And that just kind of stuck.
Yeah
Do you guys know a Victor? Maybe that was the something.
Yes, Steph's coworker Victor listened to part of one of our shows.
Okay, I don't know a Victor, so yeah. Like,
well, you do now, and he's a ghost in Anthony's house.
I mean, I get it. Yeah, I don't think I've ever been friends with a Victor.
Friends? No, I've never been friends with a Victor.
I always wanted to know a Ralph.
A Ralph?
Yeah. I don't know why. Just Ralph. It's Ralph over there. Then Wreck-It Ralph came out, and I was just like, huh, I don't know how much I want this now.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said anything. I apologize.
No, I always want to have a good camera, but...
It was like, you were two-facing it, which is, I know, your goal, but like, the dark side was fine. But that white side was like blinding. Like, you look like a bounce board. And with your new haircut, it doesn't help that there's just all skin. Shiny. Yeah, a little shiny. You're like,
yeah. And I didn't even really talk about it last week. This is all a fuck up that I had to recover.
Oh, no.
Oh, so you didn't choose that Nazi haircut?
I assumed you didn't choose it.
I did. I just assumed that was his new look. And I mean this with much love. Anthony is still trying to be like one part adult, but one part punk rock teenager. And I thought this was a happy mix in the middle, was to bick his head.
Yes, Anthony is certainly not a skinhead.
No, he knows I'm kidding.
Well, it's still mean when you say it.
Then I apologize.
Okay.
Is that a mohawk technically?
More or less.
Is it? Much love, Nazis.
Yeah.
Let's not ever say that again.
Yeah, we're not going
to
allow that.
So this was not a choice. This was oops. Did you try to do it yourself?
I've been doing it myself.
Oh. I'll send you money, man. Come on, dude. Get your hair did by a
professional.
Honestly,
it's more time. It's more of a time issue.
I can understand that.
Yeah. No, like I've been growing this top out for a while, and I've just been using my beard trimmer to trim the sides back down. Like, I haven't had a fade in a while, and only the professional does the fade. But I mean, it's the same haircut I've had for like 2 years. It's just the top's been getting longer. So I dropped my beard trimmer like a month ago, maybe 2 months ago.
You dropped it?
Yeah, I dropped my beard trimmer, which is what I use to trim. And when it broke, there's a little piece that went flying. And I'm like, well, I know it came off, but I don't know where it went. And then after a while, I started to realize, like, oh, the guard is starting to slip. So I got to be a little careful. I gotta hold it. I gotta hold it a certain way.
Yeah.
When I'm using it, otherwise, if I press too hard, the guard will move, and then it's on its lowest setting.
You know, you had a birthday last month. We all could have chipped in and bought you like a really good beard trimmer.
And yet no one did.
You didn't put it on your thing, and you didn't tell us you were having trouble.
Yeah.
Because you don't share about your hair.
Well,
caring is caring.
I didn't want anyone to contribute to my Nazism, I guess.
Your words, not mine.
Anyway,
if I had known, because there's an account I follow on Twitter, yes, Twitter, it's called the Lord of Savings, and they had a deal for a beard trimmer. And I got one, and Steph got one too. If I knew you needed one.
Steph's in our chat constantly throwing random values from that guy.
Look at this shit. This shit looks so extra.
She has it right there. She has
it ready. On deck.
I used it to touch up. No, it is extra. It's gold.
It's so nice.
So yeah. I got this for, what was it, before, like $6?
Yeah, $6. Huh? Yeah.
Steph, for before $6 you get too flat. Far.
Yeah.
Before you get too far, the show is on.
Yeah, it is. Did I curse already? Okay,
so the S word that you just dropped doesn't count.
When?
Okay. Oh, like 2 seconds ago.
No, I'll take a bean. It's fine.
No, you don't have. No, it was Anthony, not you.
No, he's saying I said it.
Yeah. Okay. Look at this.
Look, someone said
this
it.
This is
I don't
so
give
extra.
Man, that looked like a lightsaber.
It's nice.
It's like
so nice. Look, it has like, a digital readout for the battery power.
What? What the? That like, is fancy.
It's so fancy. Funny. We got it for $6.
Yeah, it was all like right, $6.
That's a pretty good deal. All right, listen.
I was like,
bad
I'll
timing.
Take it.
But how much is it now?
I have no idea. I'm not going to look at the normal price. What do I care about the normal price? I paid
because we have to buy one for Anthony, or he's gonna keep having this like white wall problem every Tuesday night.
That's fair.
Well, yeah. Anthony,
which apparently is a bad look.
What do you use already for clippers? Like, do you not have a pair?
Oh, I do.
Oh, Steph wasn't here for the portion where you
not just your beard trimming stuff, but like actual clippers.
Same.
You do. Okay.
Well, no, there's
beard trimmer does
and clippers. It doesn't, though. You think it does. It really doesn't when you have both.
It's not really that great for hair. Okay, yeah. And If I was trying to do anything fancy, then I wouldn't. You know, I would get something different. But if I'm just trying to one length around the back, and you'll love this. So for the back of my neck, you know, like if you just shave one length, it's, you know, it doesn't have a clean look to it.
Yes. Sure.
My hack, and you all can write this down, is you put a beanie on, tuck it over your ears or like behind your ears, and use that as the guard, and just use your trimmer around. It'll give you a rounded edge.
I just tie my hair up.
I have a guy,
a ponytail, and there's already a guide. I just follow it.
I have
Beck,
a guy
it's not
as
a
well.
Bowl cut because if you tuck it down, like you pull it down to the to like neck, like where the hairline more or less is. I use a mirror to kind of line it up. It is a little more curved, which is not my preference, but also, like, I don't have the option. If I want a square cut, I have to find the time to go to a barber. Mm. This is what works with this in the situation that I'm in. So Steph, this all started when I was explaining that the sides are not this short on purpose. I'd messed up when I was trimming my own hair. And when my beard shaver or my beard trimmer,
yeah,
the guard slipped as I was going up the side and just went whamp. And I just looked at myself for a second. And I'm like, oh. I said other words first, but I can't say them right now.
Did your girl come and help you at least keep it on point, or did you do that all yourself the rest of it?
I'll get my brother to come help me out because the back of my hair comes down to like kind of the base of the skull and it comes down to a point.
Yeah.
So I have him kind of work that part out, and then I can, you know, work the rest of it. The fine detail work in the back I can't do.
I've gotten pretty good when I'm shaving to just slap my hand down there in the back and just shave around the neck and call it a day.
I do the hand mirror and then the back mirror.
I don't own a hand mirror.
So I stand
mirror.
In front of the sink and then I do that.
Put it on your Amazon wish list now. So we have
go
things.
Go to Dollar Tree. They got those barber huge freaking mirrors. It's true.
And the swirly thing.
Get that for a dollar, sir.
Okay, yes. Full disclosure, I'm glad that you told us that you messed up and that that was not a choice.
Because you don't like it.
It wasn't I didn't like it. I just had serious thoughts over the weekend, actually. Me and Scott were talking about this, that I did not understand.
Scott, please contribute.
No, he just listened. He didn't really say nothing. It was more of my thought. He was my bouncing board on this. Just like... I didn't understand why you would choose to go so white because you do not do well outside. And I just felt like this is going to get sunburned so bad. And I was just like,
it's true. Yeah. You know what will help with that?
Yeah.
A bucket hat.
It would also sunblock.
I was very concerned about your new haircut because I was just like, ah, man, that's a path, I guess. That's something he need to work out. Like we were talking about people because Scott was we saw an individual walking around downtown Knott's Berry Farm that like was clearly old-ish, but dressing in his 20s, and he just looked really sad. Like in this like punk rock, like, oh, your body is not the shape that it used to be for this particular outfit. And we were talking about those people, like when you get older, you're like, well, you have to move from like a punk rock, like executive punk rock style. You have to elevate your look. And we were saying that you're elevating your look. You're trying to, but this haircut, I was like, is he trying to keep like, one foot in there, like, yeah, man. And then like, no, I'm elevated. Look, I'm wearing like nice shirts now. I had a real crisis of faith with your haircut. I'll be honest. It really kind of threw me off. This is the things I think of when I wash my hair. I think about stuff.
Oh,
Steph, what did you think? What was your opinion of my haircut?
It's fine. I've done that. It's just on one side. Like, I've done a straight, like straight, just use the, what is it? Just use the clippers, and it was just, like, a clean shave. Like, I could have looked bald. You can feel the little hairs. But it's, like, I also have this as, like, a shield. There's a lot of people that have no idea that my head is shaved. Like, I've been doing this for, I think, like, a year now, and my aunt had no clue that I did not have hair behind my head.
Don't do that. That just looks like you. God. That just looks like you when I met you.
Jesus Christ. It's Cillian Murphy from Charlie's Angels.
No.
You mean Crispin Glover?
Crispin Glover.
I was thinking Cillian Murphy. The hair guy.
I see that movie now.
I saw you were going.
I see more of Willard? Is that what that is?
Yeah, that's who it is. Yes,
Willard. Anyway. That's who I'm thinking of with that hairstyle. Yeah. It's real split.
And the idea of preference, there was no like or dislike. It was all like, oh, he's making a choice. Like, it wasn't. My thing was like, you live your life. You want to have the white walls on the side, you go ahead and have it. I just felt like maybe you were going through something.
Like, is it still like shaped or is it like skin?
It's a little fuzzy.
But you can see it's a little fuzz now. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That can grow so fast.
Look, I have messed up on this the same reason. Like, that didn't click into place properly.
Yeah.
I was going to keep it at a 6. Now it's got to be a 2. You know? It happens.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'll go straight to like the razor and then I'll be like, man, you know what? I could have kept it at a 1. I'm understanding these numbers. Like, and how people go 2 all around. And I'm just like, what do you mean by 2? And I'm like, oh.
Yeah.
That's
And taking it to the skin last week was like, man, I'm this far now, I guess. Like, what's really the difference? So then I got my actual shaver and just started working the sides of my head for like 15 minutes all before the podcast.
I'm not gonna lie, like last night I just used that to touch this up, but like I will admit this is probably more for a beard, I guess you could say, than actually this, because if you go really close, it kind of has like the what do you call that, like a like waves. On a farm, how it has like the, like, you know,
like
crops,
like when
in,
you
like,
shear
lines?
A sheep,
no, like, you know,
like when you're raking hay,
like eagle view, and you're looking at a farm and how it just has like the lines, like crop lines. That's like what it feels like is on my head, like the little things, these things have just made tiny little lines on my on the head. Does that make sense?
Absolutely not.
Is that not what?
No, Jordan and I got lost into our own bit because none of that was really making much sense.
I understand what you're saying. It's got lines.
You got waves.
You got lines.
You got grooves.
Yeah. Grooves, yeah.
I got grooves.
Stefella here got her groove back. That's all that matters.
Steph is just that working on her cosplay for Chanel West Coast from Ridiculousness.
Oh God, she laughs like a dolphin.
I guess she does. Somebody would.
No, she really laughs like a dolphin.
No,
like,
she does. She does.
Like the fucking dolphin.
Like Janice from Friends.
Like, oh, got it.
First scene of the show. All right, just for anybody who doesn't remember or happens to be new, it is No Swear September. For the entire month of September, every podcast, just the Tuesday show,
I got
we are restricted from using any curse words, which includes some very weirdly low-tier curse words.
Which I still take umbrage with, but I respect your decision.
We can't say the Kendrick Lamar album. We can't use HE double hockey sticks.
Mm-hmm. I still think that one's dumb, but all right.
Yes,
Steph down in front.
I would like to share. I just opened it. Did you get the whiff?
Caught that whiff?
Yeah. For a second, I was like, ugh, what smells? And then I was like, oh, man, I know what it is.
You know what I just realized? I ordered the 5th edition, but they shipped me the 6th edition.
I think it's what happened to Leland and I last year.
Yeah.
I really wanted the 5th edition because it had lawn clippings.
Wait, I won't look.
Okay, Steph, you go first, then I'll tell my little quick thing about the beans. Oh no,
that looks like
that's going to be a marshmallow or a stink bug.
A dirty dishwater or birthday cake.
Oh, I'm off. Okay.
Well, here we go.
Wait, Steph, what color is it?
Good luck.
It's like peach colored with like brown speckles.
It looked whitish.
Yeah, it looked whitish.
Brown speckles.
Well, it's more like... stink bug or toasted marshmallow anything else on the list.
Okay, that's what I thought.
It's...
Okay,
I hope for your sake, toasted marshmallow.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I hope so too.
But yeah.
I don't know. This whole box stinks.
Yeah, Jet, feel free to try and poke the bear if you can.
Just sucks.
Or not. You don't have to.
Okay. No, I mean it's the whole concept is pointless if we don't curse.
It's true.
You just have to try and get us.
Oh no.
I already know what it is.
Is it stink bug?
Well, yeah, I haven't even bitten into it and I know just, what it is.
You know what? Just swallow it whole. Just swallow it whole.
You gotta do it, Steph.
Stink bug messed me up so bad last year.
You gotta
year.
Take that bite.
I'm a champ.
You can do this.
I did not turn on the thing for redeeming points for beans.
It is what
by
it
way.
Is. For a second, I thought
we did
it
not discuss
me.
That.
It's not. It's very obvious. It
I thought
sucks.
We. I thought we sort of did earlier. Oh, we only did for like one concept.
Yeah. It sucks.
Let's
but
be
it's
honest.
Like more...
We started the conversation a little bit, but you were out of town. You were busy. You're in town this week. We'll discuss it more this week with. More of a conviction. Everybody drink.
10,000 points for everything.
It sucks, but it's more tame than like how I remembered it tasting.
So I ordered the fourth edition because I just wanted to try something different than the one we've been getting. They sent me the fifth edition bag that Jordan held up. And it was, remember I said, you weren't here on Sunday. Remember I said it looked a little sus and I was like, I'm all worried about it. Me and Scott looked at it. What it is it had opened in transit and it got dusty inside the bag is the only
dusty.
Way I can describe it.
Yeah.
I can't describe it anyway. It just, the beans looked old.
Yeah,
I
told
think
you not to eat them. It's not
way
worth it.
Before transit. Like, I think it was busted in the box. Like, it just looked dusty, and they were hard as like pebbles. Like, sometimes you can squish it. I was like, I'm not eating that.
That sounds like a bad thing.
But you didn't because.
Powdery. That's a better word than dusty. Powdery.
Okay. Yeah, you need to, like, get your money back.
Oh, I did. I got my $4 back.
Nice.
Okay.
But I was worried that I wasn't going to get. The new box I ordered in time because they said it wasn't going to come until like Wednesday, but unfortunately it showed up. So
yay!
They sent me the sixth edition, the one I didn't want. So,
wait,
I was like,
so we all have sixth edition?
Yeah. Unless he's got something different.
Yep.
We didn't take our photo. Can we take our photo? Because we have.
I just didn't want.
I didn't want.
Everyone smile.
Bloody bandage. I just don't want it.
Got it? Did you take it?
I thought you were taking it.
Who was taking the picture?
No, no one. We all just stood like this.
Hey, one, two, three. Okay, ready? One, two, three. Let me make sure that I actually got it, because I just print screen.
Oh, shit. I almost dropped them.
Classic.
Wait, what'd you say?
Oh, I missed it. Did he curse?
Yes.
What did you say, bud?
Yes. I said the poop word.
Oh.
And then in my head, it like got right up in queue. The F word almost came out. That's what gets you is that automatic
the spiral,
reaction word. Yeah.
So I got a new pen. It's
ooh.
A broomstick.
Oh, okay.
Dude, I'm sad.
I know everything's kind of impossible with these lights to see.
That looks red.
Like
that
it's
looks like
be
bloody
liver,
bandage.
Liver and onions
liver
or cappuccino.
And onions or cappuccino.
It was brown.
Oh, no. Yeah. I'm not excited for that one. That stayed. That taste.
I guess it was liver and onions.
Liver and onions.
Growl.
Or it's cappuccino. He doesn't like coffee.
That was his reaction for coffee. I would start laughing.
He hates coffee so much.
Gross.
What was it, cappuccino?
No.
I don't know. You might surprise me.
Yeah. Well, Could have been worse, beans. I guess. So yeah, there's an example. That's this month.
How was your trip?
It was long. It was so long. Leland, it was so long.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess.
How so, was the drive?
That's the long part.
Oh no.
So people who've been with us for a while, they know Labor Day weekend. Oh, excuse me. I'll go to my sister, my brother-in-law. They run a Japanese import snacks and collectibles business that they do conventions at. So anime conventions along pretty much any West, like the Rockies and West conventions, they go to. And for the last several years, I've been going to Phoenix, where it is insanely hot, and doing a convention called Saboten, which is fun. Great crowd. You know, everything goes well. I sell out. Everybody's happy. Yeah. Well, it had been so long that my brother-in-law, Charlie, he hadn't been there. He's like, hey, let's switch this year. You go to Sacramento. I'll go to Phoenix, and we will, because he wants to kind of like reestablish and get in touch. He feels there's some shenanigans going on, stuff like that. So I'm like, okay, you're the boss. Like, I get paid to do this. I don't get paid a lot to do this. I don't get paid my normal Monday to Friday wages, but I do it because it's a fun experience. And for family. And I like to do it. This year I went up with my girlfriend Taryn, and like I was saying, like, I wish I could make a living doing like this. This I am good at. Of all the jobs that I've had, working retail and being, you know, personable and helpful and stuff like that, I'm good at that. But you can't make a living doing that. No one makes a living doing that. Even if I did this business, I have to work all the contracts for the booths and deal with vendors and all that stuff. I'm still not doing the actual like thing that I'm good at, and that is being there at the counter, helping people out, greeting people, being friendly, all those things. So Wednesday, I pick up another dude, and the three of us, we go from San Diego to Vegas, because Vegas is where all the stock is. So Vegas, spend the night, next day, switch to a U-Haul van, and I'm driving Vegas to Sacramento, baby. Oof. And that is so effing long. It's an 8-hour drive from from either here to Sacramento or there to Sacramento. It happens to be the same. But when you add an extra 5 hours that you'd already did just to get to Vegas, now we're talking about 13 hours of driving. And it's a hard weekend. You know, like we leave early Thursday, drive all day to get there. And it's just me and her. The third guy was for another show going somewhere else. We just had to get him to Vegas.
Yeah.
But then as soon as I get there Thursday night, we got to unload. I got to set up the table, got to do all that stuff. Friday morning, the show starts. So it's just nonstop. It's fun though. It's between the opening hours, you know, weird stuff happens. One of the other workers that I had, one of the locals, her wife got into a car accident Sunday morning that was pretty rough. And I'm like, hey, do you need to go be with her? Because that's looking rough. And luckily she wasn't hurt, just shaken up. She'll probably be sore. She'll probably be bruised from the seatbelt from the looks of the photos. But stuff happens. Yeah. Stuff just happens. But the vibe is good. And like it's something you can really revel in. It's like, oh, everyone's excited. I'm out here selling, you know, these steam buns and mochi and melon bread and ramune and all the good stuff.
All the good stuff.
I got a tote bag full of snacks, man. I brought back.
Yum.
And even while I was up there, I've been to Sacramento once for this exact thing, but it was like 10 years ago. So I'd kind of forgotten. Sacramento's kind of nice. Like I'm in like downtown Sacramento.
Yeah.
And it's not as like packed and stacked as like San Diego is.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a little more, you know, a little more lush, a little more trees going on. Way more of the homeless seem to have a mental problem, which is a little discerning. A little discerning, but also sad.
Well, I just figured that's where they ship them off to.
They usually come down here where it's the weather's better.
Yeah, have you seen the episode of South Park?
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, but the city otherwise is pretty nice. Seems to be maybe having an economic crisis or something. A lot of buildings were like closed, like boarded up, closed. Still found a wine and cheese bar though. Went to a nice fancy wine and cheese bar.
That sounds nice.
I love
that. What'd you have?
Cheese.
Yep.
What kind of cheese?
Three cheeses. Don't know the name of any of them. Couldn't pronounce at least two of them. One of them from Italy.
The good stuff.
Some. Yum. Some like goat and other hybrid cheese.
Oh, that's called Parmesan.
Can somebody curse at him for me?
No, but that's what it's called though, Parmesan. Yeah.
Can someone curse at them for me? These two knuckleheads. No, this is a cheese I'd never heard of. Chevalier. Super soft. Very soft cheese. It was pretty good. We had a white sharp cheddar that was from Wisconsin. That was pretty good. I forget what the middle one was. But yeah, overall, nice little experience. I had a beer. She had wine. You know, had a nice little date up there in Sacramento. It was a good time.
That sounds nice.
Yeah. And then yesterday, I drove for 13 hours. Straight this time. After when we were loading up, when we were all done, didn't sell out, which was a big bummer. But in typical Anthony fashion, I've got this little hand cart full of sodas, a couple hundred pounds of sodas on this cart, and I'm taking it out the back loading docks. I got to get it across this little street to where the parking lot is. And as it's like going up from the street to the curb, there's always that like inch of difference. Well, it got stuck on that.
Oh, no.
So me and Virginia, my helper, we're trying to like get it. Some other dude helps us out like, oh, thanks, pal. And we all, you know, kind of lift, you got to lift it and push it enough. But when it went, I lost my balance and I slipped and I twisted my ankle.
Oh, no.
Twisted my right ankle.
Do you have something on your foot right now?
I do. Not a boot or anything. I just have an ace bandage wrapped around my foot and ankle.
Okay. I was about to say, if you had a boot, I want to decorate it.
Like a cast?
Yeah.
It's not broken.
It wasn't that bad.
Okay.
Did you go to the hospital?
No, of course not.
Then you don't know what's wrong with it.
I know it hurts.
Yeah, could be many reasons.
That's always the worst part.
It didn't bruise or anything. It swelled up a little.
It's okay. Whoever wraps it watched enough episodes of Grey's Anatomy.
Dude, yeah. That's how I feel about my leg right now. I was going up the stairs 2 weeks ago, and I slipped. I forgot if I said this story. But no. I was coming back from lunch. I slipped. And when I slipped forward, I had my lunch, my to-go box that I just got from the Uber person on my left hand. So when I slipped and I fell down, I punched my lunch. So like the small thing of vegetables had a huge punch in it. Like it was going through it. And then I started like slightly limping back to my desk. And then, like, I was just like, man, I took a fall. And then I was, like, thinking about it. And I went to check my knee if I was bleeding, which I wasn't. But, like, it's been a while. And if I touch that area, it's still sore. I really think I messed it up. It didn't turn. Like, I mean, It didn't turn any obvious, like, purple color, but it was, like, really raw to touch. And, like, now if I touch it, like, it's right on my shin. It's almost like my shin cracked. And there's, like, a little sliver that's, like, raw if you touch it.
I don't know if you cracked it.
Yeah, I don't think I did. But it's been a while, and it still kind of hurts.
Sure,
but
sure.
I mean, I think I'll be okay.
Was Steph stealing your thunder?
I guess so.
Yeah.
I mean, was it better?
What?
Her story?
No.
I mean, you didn't punch lunch.
I did not punch lunch, no. Yeah. I just ate it into, like, some dirt, laughed it off, and got up and didn't realize for, like, an hour that my ankle was starting to hurt.
Oh, so kind of like when you fell out of that car AbFab style at Disneyland a couple years ago and really messed up your, was it your knee?
Yeah.
We were talking about that last week.
Still have a scar.
Yeah, weren't we were talking about that on Sunday?
Yeah, like, you said that he tried to pull it off and yeah. He was just like, da-da! Like, it was like no, a ha-ha!
Yeah.
But it was...
We talked about that while Anthony was off doing whatever he was doing and being haunted by a ghost.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. What? So you fall down, you feel the momentum, you just roll back to your feet, and if you throw your hands up in a presentation... All the more fun for everybody. I don't know why you got to come down on me for being a showman.
I'm not coming down on you. Just making a statement that you do hurt
for
yourself
being
more than
a
anybody
showman.
Else.
I don't know. Oh, it's persecuting me because of my love to perform.
I can't help it. I'm an entertainer at heart.
I don't know. I think I just get in weird situations. Like, I forgot if I mentioned this on the podcast, but a couple weeks ago, too, I went into the supply room and I was trying
Where
to reach for
going?
A box of envelopes. And I was reaching, and what I didn't know was there was another box on top of it, but not in my view. So when I pulled the envelopes back, another box filled with, like, keys, like, just various car keys. No,
why do you have a box
car
keys? Keys?
No,
why
So
Why
I guess
are
all
car
the...
keys in the supply room of an insurance company?
So, like, I guess all the cars, all the salvage vehicles, when they gave the keys, I don't know, they gave the keys. There was just a box of keys.
Yeah, we should never have those keys.
We got a lot of those keys. Yeah.
But anyways.
Yeah, well, a lot of people mailed those keys to us.
Oh, because they're idiots.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
I say us, like, I still work there.
This box, so I get the envelopes, this box of keys falls. It falls on me and onto the floor. And it's loud. And it's long. It's just keys falling. And
Forever.
Then everyone
Some
heard.
Say they're still falling.
Everyone heard that crash. And me just going, I'm fine. And then everyone just started dying because it was just like, Steph, are you good? I was like, I'm okay. It's just a lot of keys fell.
That's because, Steph, you are a human cartoon.
Yeah, not wrong.
I was trying to get out of the U-Haul the other day, and I got stuck because my backpack hoop got latched to the seatbelt. And when I was trying to get out of the car, it wasn't letting me. And Rosanna was like, what is happening? I was just like, I'm stuck. I'm stuck. And yeah, I just, you know, it happens. Yep.
Yep.
Why were you in a U-Haul?
Oh, I was helping my mom move.
Ah.
When she said she got stuck, did anyone else think of Pooh Bear?
Like, stuck with honey?
Oh,
like a honey jar?
Like, Pooh Bear tries to
like
get out
of... Like in the knot
of
a tree.
He gets, like, stuck in the knot of a tree.
Yeah. Oh, bother.
Oh, bother.
Oh, bother.
And then Rabbit makes a table out of his butt.
What?
Yes. Yeah. Don't they eventually make, like, a smiley face and his little
yep.
tail is, like, the nose?
Yeah.
Okay, I've seen that clip, too.
They ate lunch off that ass.
Oh! Damn it! That can't. Yeah, double! Double! All right.
You're keeping track, right, Elin?
I got the tally.
Okay,
yeah,
good.
I was about to ask, are you keeping track?
Nice. Let's get everyone on the board tonight.
Like, oh, that's initial smell.
It's not good. It's awful. Like, I.
Oh, why did I go for more?
It just goes in, like, just nose first.
Yeah.
Box didn't smell as bad.
Really? Yeah, no.
Maybe. I also didn't stick my nose in it.
I didn't stick my nose in it either, but it was very obvious. Okay. I'm just kind of glad it's not as hot as it normally is, because I've had to put this in.
Oh, man, you just jinxed it, Steph.
All right, here we go.
Now I gotta look.
Oh, no.
You know what? I gotta, wait, do them both at the same time.
Okay, this is either booger or pear. This is either barf or peach. So bad either way.
Yeah, you always got to do the beans one at a time.
Do you? I mean, I wonder if it would be better if you did them both at the same
time. Doesn't matter what's better.
Here it goes. Booger or pear first.
Okay. He hates pear, too.
I like pears.
He hates peach.
I knew it was something with a peach.
Okay.
I do enjoy a good pear.
It's pear.
When was the last time you had a pear?
Pair of these. It seemed like the appropriate moment. I didn't know.
And it was the right moment.
It was exactly the right moment. No notes. No notes.
No notes, yeah. That's.
I wish I did this one first then.
I don't think it was this year. It might have been last year.
Like you bite it like an apple?
What?
Like you take a pear and you bite it like an apple?
Oh yeah. Oh. I eat it exactly like an apple.
It's peach.
It's peach. It's so disgusting.
This makes the whole ratio even worse for Jordan.
It does. It does.
Since some of the good flavors he also finds to be disgusting.
I'm drinking like peach nectar, and it's like I bit into a peach. It's so good. Okay.
Like, it's really good. An actual peach, delicious. Artificial peach, not delicious. Artificial peach.
Yeah.
And by peach, you mean the fruit, correct?
Nah.
if nah and that look were a curse word, you just did it. Anthony, I'm going to go on a limb. Both of those are pretty bad, but one is better than the other.
What is the bottle?
Are you talking about the alcohol?
I saw the word Tito, so I'm assuming it's some sort of tequila.
No. Tito's vodka.
What is it?
Yeah, Tito's vodka. It's vodka.
Still bottom shelf. Not good.
Oh.
You can have some of your scotch.
I feel like Leland just is mean for no reason sometimes. Yeah. He doesn't even know what he's talking about. He just wanted to say something mean.
No. I'm dieting. Leave me alone.
Remind me to put these beans in the Ziploc bag later.
Yeah. No, I will too.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend your bottom shelf vodka.
It's not, though. It's like empirically
It's like middle shelf at best.
Popular,
it's middle high.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of people get that one.
It's above your Smirnoff and your Skies.
Well, like everything's above those because those are literally the bottom shelf. Like
there's your Gordon's is at the bottom. Your it's plastic right next bottles to it. Are the bottom. Tito's is like debatable per preference, but like Goose or just below Goose.
Goose is almost the highest you can go.
No, yeah.
In some bars, yes. In a widely available market, yes, Goose is about the top.
Goose is what people who don't know what good vodka is, they think that's the top shelf.
Yes,
but there is higher.
No, I know there's higher.
Yeah. Well, so I'm not speaking.
Yeah, Costco.
There's a U.S. top 6 vodka brands.
Okay.
Number one. Hit us with the Steph's list.
Steph's list.
Number one is Tito's.
Mmm.
Number
two
is
Leland Austin, baby.
Even one more bad thing about it.
Yeah. It's like, specifically.
Just keeps getting worse, Anthony. Yeah.
U.S. top 6 vodka brands is what it said. So Tito's is number one.
Everyone in and from Texas buys it.
Ooh, two is Smirnoff?
This list is not good.
Is New Amsterdam. Amsterdam's pretty popular, I think.
I don't know. I've
got that
one. Svedka. I'm sorry, what'd you say?
Svedka.
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 It's the Swedish one that always has an American flag bottle in July.
Yes. I like Svedka.
That is true.
They know what's up.
Svedka's not bad.
Yeah.
I'll take Svedka over a Smirnoff every time.
Five is Absolut.
Oh,
Absolut's good.
I forgot about Absolut, to be honest.
I'm down for an Absolut.
Which Absolut flavor?
Oh, yeah, I don't know. And six is Kettle One.
Ooh. I also forgot about Kettle One.
Kettle One's pretty decent.
I think I've never had Kettle One. A lot.
Yeah, Tito's and Kettle, I feel, are like an even level shelf.
Anthony, Tito's is already on the list. You don't have to keep, you know.
You're endorsed by Mr. Tito.
You know Tito himself.
We are not sponsored by Tito's handmade vodka, but if we were, that'd be awesome.
It would be really awesome, actually.
I mean, I'll take the sponsorship, but I ain't gonna drink your nasty stuff.
We're not gonna get sponsored. Things like that.
No, sponsors. It's a character. It's a bit. He's just doing a bit.
It's a bit. He's not like this all the time.
We love Tito's.
Love it. He's got Tito's in his closet right now.
You can see him? What?
Yeah, he's ball gagged and bound up.
You
got
them
all shibari'd in the closet.
For my vodka, I like to go outside the U.S., so I just, I like stuff that's not, you know, bad. I couldn't think of another word. I'm sorry.
I'm fine with the Kirkland Grey Goose knockoff.
Yeah.
That's really good.
Yeah, yes. That one's really good, and sometimes that's only $12.
Yeah.
And
I dip into it whenever I'm at my dad's house.
The fattest bottle.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Because I work there, I just can't.
I know.
I just can't.
That's fair.
I know.
Yeah, but they did, though.
You didn't, though. It wasn't made in the Costco.
Yeah, but I made it a
purchased.
Lot.
It was just purchased and distributed.
They're just
and
so
do you
bad.
Never go into the Costco anymore?
I don't. My dad will take me when I go down because he needs help, but I don't personally go into one.
They got a lot of good deals.
I'm sure they do. It's blood money and I just don't like to be a part of it.
Oh. You got Bobo's on a good deal.
I don't know what that means.
You
is
say
that a
Bobo?
Is that a dog?
Yeah, Bobo's. What?
No, these are delicious, like sandwich cookies. I don't know what to call them.
They're like sandwich cookies.
Can't just say the same thing I said.
It's like, I don't know how to explain it.
Is it like an Oreo?
So there's two. Think of like Crustables, Uncrustables.
But yeah, cookie.
What the heck's a Crustable?
Uncrustable.
Oh, that don't make it better.
It's
crustable, uncrusted. I still don't know what it is.
Where were you in 1998?
Getting laid.
Mm-hmm. Or I was 8 years old, sir.
So Jordan clearly not getting laid.
Only laying that was happening was my bed with me on it.
Yeah, no, but Bobo's. To describe it, that's not like that's the name of the brand, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
But there's two flavors. There's grape
strawberry and grape.
Strawberry, but essentially think like I don't know. It's not granola.
It's like a PB and J sandwich, but no.
Yeah, it's almost
butter?
Like that.
Yeah, but it's like oats.
An empanada.
It's like an oat cookie
with the filling
of grape or strawberry.
With peanut
like
butter.
Oats.
Yeah, it's just like a good snack.
Yeah, it's
like
delicious. It's so good.
Yeah.
I crave them sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, you throw one of that in your bag, you're
driving.
It kind of
sounds like a
you feel
dream.
Like you need a snack, and just Bobo's.
Watch.
Bobo's, baby.
Just one day, Anthony, when you least expect it, Steph's going to be like, "Hey, Anthony.
Are you Bobo's?
Where are you? I have Bobo's. You want one?
I brought you Bobo's.
Is that your Steph voice?
I wasn't prepared for the voice that came out.
Yeah.
I'm Steph.
Yeah.
I got Bobos. I love them.
I don't sound like
S-T-E-P-H-U-H-N-O-I-D-S.
Why do I sound like Mickey Mouse?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
You did a good job.
Oh, man.
Let's run this train, Goofy.
Oh, God. No.
Of course.
That's what he talks about. Those people that go picnicking.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness. Yeah.
So 14 hour drive. Great. I'm glad you're alive. I'm sorry that you're tired.
Yeah. It is bad. Can we say we can say sucks, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Just checking.
You just did.
I mean, do I get penalized for it?
No.
No.
Okay. No. It sucks. And with my foot messed up, and we were kind of under pressure to get back to Vegas by 7. Under so pressure. I did pretty much all the driving because I was going to drive fast. And
what?
Surprise.
You like cars?
I was doing 90 in a U-Haul van.
Not shocked by any of this statement.
Yeah, no one is. We had to rush it. Make sure we got back on.
Did
time
you cuss?
And whatnot.
Huh? No, I said what is it? He likes cars and he likes to go fast. And then Jordan was having a reaction
fast.
And said, "This one's for you."
Yeah. No, because years and years and years ago, when I was describing the movie Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift to Steph, I said, I was at the movie with the wife who goes, I like cars, I like going fast. And
I believed him.
Nailed it.
Thought that was
actually in the movie. And I would say it every time. And we would joke about it every time.
Like,
and then when we went to Evo and we watched it and it was never said, and I was like,
she was waiting for it. She was waiting for it the whole time.
Yeah, I waited. I didn't hear it.
Is it like in the trailer or something? And they didn't put it in the movie?
In Steph's defense, though, if Lucas Black's character said that, I would not have been shocked.
Yeah, I know.
No, it sounds exactly right.
I like cars, I'm going fast.
With his terrible,
real
southern accent. Yeah.
Look, Twink, I like cars, not going fast. This dude's for Han.
I believed him. Jordan also said, why would you believe me? And I was like, because you're friend. Why would you're my friend. Why would you lie to me?
Yeah, well, that's just how it goes.
For a bit. With the exception of Steph, anybody here will lie to anybody else for a bit.
Oh, yeah, 100%. And no, Jets, you're thinking of Too Fast, Too Furious, where Paul Walker says, "Cuh," for the first time when talking to Tyrese Gibson in Barstow.
Wait.
Ah, Barstow.
Yeah,
I ain't going back to Barstow.
Barstow's so bad.
It sucks.
It's weird. I was describing Barstow as like this weird, like, waypoint because it only exists to get gas.
Yeah,
but and there's like nothing else by it. So to have people work there, you need to have people living there.
Yep.
And so you have people living there, then you need the other support of like grocery stores and stuff like that.
Yep.
Yeah. So its entire existence is just to have a point between Baker's and whatever is before.
Yeah.
But like you have to have this whole like small city, and it has gotten surprisingly large.
It has. Yeah. They have the outlet mall now.
Yeah. Like I remember.
How many Walmarts?
Zero.
I don't know.
I only went to one. There or a Target.
He says there's one.
There's a Walmart.
There's a Food for Less. I didn't know you were gonna call me out on it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, he said there wasn't, so I was, because my joke was gonna be if they're bored on a Friday night, do they decide to go to the Walmart on one side of town or the Walmart on the other side of town?
No, but no, everyone just goes to the train station.
They just go to the train station. Yeah.
I can't wait till that train is up and running. They're working on a high speed rail out that way to Vegas.
I want to go on a train vacation.
There is There is a Walmart in Barstow.
A singular Walmart?
Well, I mean, I looked up Walmart Barstow, and this is the one that I gave me. And it is down, like, a few blocks, I guess, from the train station. So there is
a train station.
Yeah.
No,
I went to the food for less. I wasn't going to look around for anything else. It was right off the freeway.
Well, you've never been to the Barstow train station?
No.
I'm not going there.
What?
I stop by there. I buy a lotto ticket.
What me?
They got really good jerky. I like stopping by there. They got a lot of fun stuff.
Yeah, it's filled with tchotchkes.
If we ever do a road trip to Vegas.
I've only been to Barstow a few times, and we're stopping by Barstow. Well, I don't need to stop by Barstow.
No, we are.
No, but see, like, from my drive, I don't have to go through Barstow.
Yeah, but really? We do.
But we want to.
You all can stop.
LoRC goes to Barstow.
I'm not taking my one vacation in Barstow.
We're not staying in Barstow. We're driving through Barstow.
Wait, hang on. How long do you want to stay in Barstow, Steph?
Just to stop by, get a refreshment, and leave.
That's exactly the purpose of Barstow.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
So there's no need to do anything that involves a train.
You go to the train thing, so you walk through, you're like, look, they changed it to this. Oh, look, they made a place now.
Unless that train station is a gas station, I'm not going.
It's so interesting.
Is it?
It's not that bad in there. Yeah. It's so weird. It's like a huge, giant, like, bazaar.
Yeah.
It's made to leave, Beck says.
It is. But, like, I was saying,
Beck,
like,
honestly, that's how I figured the whole part could go past in there. LA to Sacramento. Everything in the middle is just made to
buy a machete and dip. Like, they got so many things in there.
Buy a machete,
get some jerky, you know, go about your day.
Get yourself a nice, what are those sweaters?
Cable knit?
No, what is it? Those, the Mexican sweater things?
Poncho?
The serape?
I don't know. Whatever the Mexican blanket materials are, and the jacket version of that.
Oh, they make it like a sweater.
Yeah, they have a bunch of those. Get yourself a knife. Just some tickets. I didn't know what they were called.
L sweater. Wait,
okay. No, I think I brought this up on the show before, but like, did we all have those? Because we all kind of grew up in the San Diego area. Did we all have one of those blankets in our house?
I had a Mexican blanket. It went on the couch.
They're amazing. This is not like making fun of the Mexican blanket.
It's so comfy.
But like, it was such a thing that only certain regions like fully have. Like, we have like four still at my house.
I don't have any anymore, but we had like a teal, white, and gray one.
Oh, we had a gray and blue one. It was my favorite. It was more comfortable than the brown and blue one.
Oh, okay.
I had a blue and white one with two lions on it.
I had a big blue one and a big red one.
What's that, Jordan?
I had a big blue one and a big red one.
And a big red one. Oh.
Jordan, nice. Steph.
I get a purple one now.
Did either of you do anything exciting over the weekend?
I watched Equalizer 3 in 4DX.
So you felt every punch that Denzel hit people with?
And every spray of blood in her face.
Yeah.
That's the thing that I really wanted to know. That was my first thought. And I even told Jordan, because Jordan already watched it. I was just like, at 4DX, it's going to have the water setting. I'm going to keep it on. But is the water for water, or is the water blood? And then he was just like, I think it's blood. It was very much for blood.
Gnarly.
But some scenes, if it was implied that there was blood spatter, you got messed up. Or like I won't go into depth, but like example, if someone was if someone was struggling on the floor and like their legs were struggling because they were like getting strangled, I guess you could say. Yeah, there's like this little thing on the bottom of the seat, like a little wispy thing.
Oh no.
It will like
So you can experience being murdered.
It's like this little string.
Experience
and it's
every murder Denzel commits.
It's like little, it just like teeters and like you can feel it on your ankles.
No, Anthony, wow. he doesn't murder, he equalizes.
He does.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. They're leveled to the ground.
If there was like if it was windy or gust like you would feel a gust of wind.
Yeah.
The environmental thing.
Like the fans would go. So or like spat it would on. Feel cold at 1 second.
Environmental
and
stuff makes sense though.
Yeah. And then when there's lightning, it will flash.
Yeah, it'll flash in the room.
It'll flash in the theater.
I still haven't done it. I kind of want to.
It's fun.
I'll go next time.
I think I'll get motion sickness in the first 20 minutes and
run. 100%.
It actually wasn't so bad. Like there was a car scene at the beginning, and your seat just like revs as you're in the car. But this wasn't like Uncharted where I told you like. When there was like a conversation scene, it was like swaying like this. It didn't do that. No, it didn't do that at all. This one was more of like if someone got punched or hit, like every now and then you would feel like a hit.
Like a little burst on your back.
Like a little person would pop up off each seat and hit you.
like shotgun shots. Whew. I felt that one. I was like, man.
Wow. I know exactly what shit you're talking about.
I had a great time. I had a good time. It was just me. I was like,
my trainer also went to see it, and he also very much enjoyed it.
Yeah, it's a fun movie.
It was a fun time.
Third act, very rushed, but otherwise, you know.
Yeah.
Do you have to have seen Equalizer 1 and 2 to understand who he is?
No.
No, not really.
He's just out there equalizing.
Is he what's his profession? I mean, like, if he was to hand you a card, does it say equalizer on it?
Lyft driver.
Taxi man.
Is he like one of those guys that just something bad happens around him and he's like, I have a certain set of skills. I can handle this situation for this.
Yep. Well, back in the 90s, he used to be a regulator, but now times have changed.
I don't get that joke.
Warren G. Regulators.
Regulators.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a Scott joke.
Scott's laughing.
I hope so. I don't.
Yeah, me too. He's laughing somewhere.
Tell us in the chat if you're laughing. Yeah.
Put it in the chat.
Maybe he's busy.
I'm trying to think what else. Moving.
But it's also a Young Guns reference.
I had K barbecue this weekend.
Nice.
You had what?
A Korean barbecue. So we have a Korean barbecue place here that I really like. You kind of pay a little bit more, but it's more buffet style. So you pick all the ones you want and then bring it back versus waiting on someone to give you stuff.
I see.
So you don't cook it?
No. You still cook it.
You go and get the raw meat at a trough.
You get what you want.
At a trough?
I really do like it, honestly, though, because, like, I've had a lot of experiences where we'll, like, ask for a plate of whatever. Like, oh, we want, what is it? Like, let's say you want pork belly. And then you only want one slab of pork belly. But they give you like three, and it's just like I just wanted the one. Like
no, because no one just asked for one.
Look,
yeah, Seth, I don't understand this problem.
Yeah,
that's why you always take a human garbage disposal, like your boy, whenever you go to K barbecue.
Yeah, but man,
get that bulgogi.
When we went for Scott's birthday in June, we wanted some shrimp. And I took very much a lot of umbrage with how the shrimp was presented to us because it was just brought out like, here, we caught this. Here you go. Like, it was not.
Oh, it wasn't de-shelled or anything?
Like, it wasn't de-shelled or anything.
Ready to go
like
whatsoever. The eyes and legs are still there and the pooper and everything. And I was like, okay, one, I don't know how to cook this. Do you have tools? And she was like, no, Okay, so not only do you not bring me the tools to do such things, I don't know how to do these things.
Yeah.
And you are just presenting it like this, and I'm supposed to know what to do with it? Like, I was just kind of like, I paid a lot of money, so I think you should have that shrimp prepared.
Yeah, like or already.
Maybe you pay
like,
to have them cook it.
What do you call that?
That's
de-vein?
Not what we went Korean barbecue, Anthony. That's not what we went to do.
De-shelled and de-veined. I think that's what it is, the terminology.
Yeah. It was just kind of like, so we didn't eat it. Like, we just sat there. I think we cooked one.
That's fair.
it was freezing cold. So even when you started getting in there, your fingers got numb.
Got
so you
cold.
Couldn't, like, it was just.
That's kind of why, like, I'm still not comfortable to get K-Barbecue, like, by myself or, like, as the leader of the group. I still need a Sherpa to guide me, like, here's how to do it. Here's. Like what you run into, and like here's
that's
like
fair.
A consistent place. Yes, Leland.
Did you say as the leader of the group or
yes?
Oh,
yeah. Because I'm
no,
not
no, Steph,
lie.
Hold. So you think you're the leader of the group?
If it is,
what he means.
If it's my idea, and I'm like, we should go. I'm gonna put
everyone's
a group
gonna
together.
Look at you,
they look like, to me because there is always like a person at the table. That leads the cooking. Others may contribute, but there's typically one that runs that. That can't be me. I don't have the experience.
Yeah. Check the hair. He's the alpha male.
So like when we went to Vegas, Jordan was in charge. He was the leader.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Was I? When we go to Disneyland, I'm in charge.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Steph? What do you get to take us to where you're in charge?
I don't know.
All right,
I don't know
yet. We'll come back to Steph.
I'm in charge in the sense that I'm pretty sure I got what you need. You just got to tell me what you want, and I will provide it.
She's got what you need, son.
You can have whatever you like.
Well, usually it's just like, oh. Does anyone have this? You know what? I might. Let me check my stuff, and I might.
Steph's a drug dealer.
That's not what we're talking about, Steph. We're not talking about like your purse of holding that's got like
everything
random thing you can need. But like where we go to a place where you are the most experienced individual to lead us through whatever. The scenario entails.
Let's see. I could bring you to a Jamba Juice. I could bring you to a Smash
Jamba
Burger.
Juice.
I could bring
again
you
with
to
the Jamba
City.
Juice.
I could bring you to.
She's gonna kill
a
it
Smash
at
Smash Burger.
She's gonna kill it at the lunch court.
You know, someone the other day in the store. Hold on. You know, is my nutritionist said Jamba Juice, and I instantly rolled my eyes. Like, or not instinctively, it was like, oh god, we get
the bit,
it.
The bit has entered your brain.
Steph, you could take us crystal shopping. I will lead.
Oh,
you would
okay.
be the lead of that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, that sounds awful, things. But I'll do it for you.
I will have so
have
many questions.
Things.
I would give you 10 minutes of my time in a crystal shop before the woman behind the counter named Melody. I have to go. No, I just like, I'm out. I can't do this.
That's fair. They have fun stuff in there.
Like the drummer from Josie and the Pussycats?
Man, I don't know their names.
Josie?
Melody?
The black one.
That was her name? Melody?
No, she didn't. Her name wasn't the black one, Steph.
No, I said, was her name Melody? Of course it's not the black one. That's incredibly rude.
Look,
Melody was the drummer.
Look, there's Josie, Ahsoka, and the blonde one who, from the E channel. They just were videotaping waiting to watch die. Tara Reid.
Oh.
Well, that stopped the show dead. All right. Well, I guess that's the end of the night.
You were being mean.
I was being mean to a person named Melody, who
Josie
is not a person in existence, by the way. You just said, let me quote, Rosario Dawson as the black one. That's offensive to all things that the beautifulness that is Rosario Dawson.
I have never seen the movie in which you speak of. I was thinking about the cartoon.
I was thinking about the cartoon.
I didn't even think the cartoon. So I went right to the movie.
I kind of forgot there was a movie.
That movie is fantastic.
There's so many ads, like running ads in that movie. It's hilarious.
I've never seen the movie.
Jordan, it's actually quite funny. You might actually really enjoy it.
Wait. Jet, are you quoting Leland? Did he say the F word?
I did not. There's no way. I am keeping my stuff on tight tonight.
Okay. All right.
I know you said I'm out. Just taking liberties. I don't remember what you said before.
No.
I think you just
taking liberties.
I meant that, but I didn't say it.
It was inferred.
Yeah.
Oh.
We felt it, but we didn't hear it.
It was in lowercase.
Jordan, did you do anything this weekend that was fun?
Oh, I just played Armored Core, and it was great. Okay. So good. If you ever want to play a Gundam game, Armored Core 6 is the closest you'll ever get.
Oh, that's what we
not counting those Gundam games.
Not counting those Gundam games.
I
we watched Equalizer 2. And then
Yes. Also
Friday night was Equalizer 2.
I played a little bit of Baldur's Gate this morning.
How'd that go?
What did you
I died.
You died?
I died. Like, straight up. The game ended. I died. They were like, your party is dead. You have to reboot. I was like, cool.
What did you do? Actually, I don't want to know.
It's fair.
Oh, okay.
I died bad.
Yeah. Wait, can I share the one part that I did when we were playing?
Nope.
No?
It's not even beginning.
But I want to know.
No, you have to play to know.
You have to make your own mistakes.
I don't want to die.
Fine. Can I just say the options then, but not what I chose or what happens? Just what I saw.
I feel like we'd be able to infer.
That's a Jordan call.
I feel like we'd be able to infer what you chose when you give the options.
No, because it said was, okay, there was a thing in the middle of the room. That's all it said.
Mm-hmm.
Then it said you can investigate. Or you can breach in.
By mimic?
No mimics.
That's all it said.
Not yet.
There was a
Not
thing yet. In the middle of the room. My options were to 1, investigate. 2, reach into it. Or 3, leave.
I didn't even get true. That far to whatever that is. Jordan, to give you a perspective, that first thing you're on didn't even make it out of that.
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Did Leland die in the tutorial?
Yes.
Yeah.
I did too, no?
No, you didn't die. I was there to save you. I totally just remembered. This just came in.
Ooh.
It's the Blu-ray for Across the Spider-Verse.
How cool. Nice. It looks
and
pretty.
This came in as well.
Ooh.
Dang.
That's
that
pretty.
Game's not out yet, though,
it's
right?
It's not out, no.
Oh, okay. No.
It's out in, like...
October,
yeah.
Yeah, I was like...
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, did I miss it?
No. But I'm
only pre-ordered Mortal Kombat for next week.
But I missed my chance to get the plates for my PS5, so I settled for the controller.
What, there's you eBay, maybe?
I'm not going to do that. I'm going to wait for... I'm gonna hope for a restock.
He ain't that rich.
Yeah, because people are scalping.
I gotta get a new
controller.
I'm starting to drift in my current controller.
You've been saying that for weeks, though. This ain't new.
Yeah,
get one of these. Just get one of these.
The pros.
Yeah, it's $200, but I haven't had a single issue.
But Anthony, the real one is $80.
Yeah, that's a $120 difference. That's a whole nother controller.
I'm just saying, you wearing something expensive on your wrist right now.
Yeah, and I'm trying to walk it off, literally.
That's the second time you've made that joke in 2 weeks.
Yes.
Well, it's what I'm doing.
How's that walk? You walked a lot this weekend, I bet.
Yeah, I did. Yeah. I got a gang of steps. I don't know how to look it up, but...
Just my swipe goodness. Like 3 times.
I wasn't talking to you!
Well, we made it about us.
He's yelling at his watch, Steph.
Yeah.
No, I know. I know. I know.
Whoa. Steph gave attitude when she was looking at her phone.
Yeah.
Did I really?
Yes.
It's a little sass. Even feel it.
You gave Leland sass.
Lass.
My bad.
Oh, doesn't Starfield come out on Game Pass tomorrow?
I thought it was already out. I've been told by a coworker to get it on Game Pass already.
Yes, because it's out on Early Access. If you paid for the Deluxe Edition, you got to play it since like Friday. But it comes out on Game Pass, I believe, tomorrow, which it's already loaded on my Xbox. I've been waiting for it.
I thought the character creation was very fun.
Oh, yeah.
Are we back to Baldur's Gate?
Yeah, we're back to Baldur's Gate, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I enjoyed the character creation. Thought it was fun.
Yeah.
How big that peen?
Well, I made a woman.
How big them boobies?
You can't make the boobies big.
Yeah.
Well, maybe you can, but I was a dragonborn, and apparently they don't have breasts. So,
yeah.
But it did give me the option of penis or vulva.
Yes, yeah.
I saw that.
Which I thought was funny. And then it was like, do you want to wear clothing? And I was like, no.
Yeah.
And then I made her a dude just to see the dragonborn peen. And then I was like, yep.
That's what that looks like.
That's what that looks like. And then I went back to the vulva.
Is it like Shape of Water where like there's a thing, there's like a flap that opens or something?
You can have that option. Look, your options are ambiguous, peen, or vulva. That's your three options. So,
yeah.
And
also,
you have
nudity on.
Yeah, nudity on.
But nudity off when
for
we
the stream.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Well, nudity off when we stream.
Yeah. Well, whoever's streaming has to have nudity off, and then everyone else could have it on.
Everyone, everyone else can go buck wild.
Yeah, because this is not going to show.
I thought it was a very pretty game, but it has the same problems that I have in real D&D. Is I was like, ah. Still gotta wait my turn. So,
yeah, that's okay.
Tried to flank. Mm-hmm. They didn't know what that was. I was like, I'm flanking.
It's an optional rule.
I was like, all right. No, I enjoyed it, but I died very quickly. And I was like, I am not good.
What'd you make?
A dragonborn.
Class.
Oh, we gotta get druid.
Okay.
I'm just playing
around. This ain't when we make our characters. I still haven't decided what creature I want to be because I don't want to be me. I mean, I want to be me, but a creature.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, fantasy you. We're gonna make fantasy versions of ourselves for the Baldur's Gate LoRC campaign.
That was. That guy also made
tiefling.
Tiefling.
Yeah.
I don't know why they had me make a second thing. I was confused by that.
Your guardian. So I believe that's just like another NPC that'll help you. Just
okay.
Yeah.
I made her storm.
Nice.
No, it was fun, Anthony. I think you really like it, but it was. I had issues. Like the tutorial didn't really tell you how to do anything other than like walk. It was just like, you can walk. It's like, great. I didn't know how to attack. I had to figure all that out on my own.
Yeah,
I was a little disappointed.
Oh, yeah,
like, you're supposed to tell me stuff.
Yeah, you have to turn on tooltips.
Good.
Yeah,
they're kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll that's why too. I died.
That would make sense.
Yeah. Anyway,
I'm looking forward to the LRC campaign.
Yeah. We'll start that up like next week or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
What is that? I went demon. Right? I always forget.
Tiefling.
Tiefling.
Tiefling fighter is what I went for.
Nice.
Yeah.
I'm thinking I'm going to go tiefling warlock.
Okay. I'm going to be a dwarf cleric.
Your black dwarf looked badass.
You were right. Jordan said it looked like Xavier Woods, but shrunk. And I showed Scott, and even Scott was like, it's like Xavier Woods, but like tiny. I was like, yeah.
Yeah. He put it into our chat.
I mean, like I said, it had some real Dinklage energy going. So
it was pretty rad.
Ooh, did Anthony curse?
Oh. What did I say?
I don't
I didn't even hear it.
I honestly don't remember. It went.
My radar isn't quite like tuned up yet.
Yeah, we're still at the beginning of this.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it though. I'm gonna do it. So that's I pulled out too many.
Oh, talking about my character.
Got it.
Oh yeah.
So that counts, even though that's not specifically the word, but it was a conjunction. Like, is that?
Yeah, I think.
Okay,
yeah.
Just checking.
Conjunction.
Because you're not talking Ask the Burrow, the jackass. That's a different word.
Oh wait, okay.
He's in an explanation mode.
Go allow it. Would that be kind of like if? Never, you know. Oh, ooh, no.
Wait,
is that red?
What edition do you have?
Yeah,
I think six.
He's got the one with the bloody bandage.
Oh no, we all have bloody bandage.
We all got bloody bandage.
Well, old bandage.
Or
we always say bloody.
Yeah, we do because that's what it tastes like.
Yes.
Yeah. The copper.
I would say get your the Tito's copper ready next to you just in case.
Yeah.
It's not early enough in the show to take a shot. It's not worth it.
I meant to wash down the flavor of that.
Well, for those of us who are drinking, we can take the optional shot instead of the bean.
Oh. Yeah, but no, we're talking about as a chaser.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, well, I don't. I got my king of beers.
I mean, how can you tell the difference between that beer and the bandage?
Like, you just have piss water with you. I don't know how that's going to help.
Does that count?
Does that count?
Yes.
Whatever.
Really?
It does?
I'm just going to say yes. All right. Yeah, Beck is also in agreement.
Whatever.
Really?
I don't care.
I don't find it bad.
All right, here we go. This is the it's either stink bug or toasted marshmallow. Fantastic. Oh,
gross.
No. He got the band-aid. Yep,
well.
Oh, no. It's not good.
That shot sounded better now, don't it?
Ah!
It's
oh,
not
I thought
good.
He said the F word.
Here I go, I guess.
Oh, I went all last year without a used bandage. Oh, God.
That stink bug.
Oh, no.
Oh, that was my first bandage.
Stink
bug.
Was yours real potent? Mine wasn't as bad as it normally is.
No,
it's not good.
It's strong.
Oh.
Every year we do this. It's great.
I'm sorry, guys.
Best shows of the year.
Yeah.
I don't know. I like Halloween. We get costumes.
You like Halloween everything.
Yeah, but I like it better than this.
This is...
Speaking of Halloween, has anyone got any costume stuff at all?
Nope.
I know what I'm doing.
All four? Five?
Yes.
Four. All. Four.
Yeah, why are we not doing one on Halloween? What are we doing instead?
Not doing this.
Know. Why? What's on your docket? What are you going to do instead of this?
I don't know. It's Halloween. I don't want to do this. I want to go do something. It's Halloween. You should feel the same way.
I see what you... I understand.
I'm going to make the executive decision that we won't have a podcast because it's my birthday.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah, Jordan's going to spend it with family this year.
Yeah.
Okay.
That stink bug was gross.
George's gonna wear his Little Mermaid costume to whatever birthday party they go to.
He's gonna go to a Ruth's Chris in a Little Mermaid costume.
No, Ruth's Chris. Probably not a Ruth's Chris.
Oh, man, from what I've been told.
You're not a fan.
I'll probably go to Fogo de Chao again because
yeah.
I love Fogo de Chao.
You could get grilled pineapple.
Yeah, and get that bread though.
And the bread.
The yucca
really
cheese
bread.
Oh, oof. Lordy, lordy, lordy.
So, Anthony, you know what you're doing for your four, but you have not purchased anything.
Yes.
Jordan, any purchases have been made?
Nope.
Okay. Do you know what you're doing at least?
I'll figure it out.
All right. Steph?
Do you have like a list to pare down?
I have one. I have one already. I have ideas, but not purchased yet.
I guess yes, I do have one in mind.
Yeah, I have all one. Right.
I figured it out over the weekend.
I have two or three.
What do you mean you figured it out?
The list of costumes.
I thought you meant I figured out what Jordan was doing. I was like, how?
Oh, no. I figured it out.
It's like, I have three for sure ideas, and I have purchased a few items for one of them.
Right on. Mm. Does anyone think they've got a real banger?
No.
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 I think I might have a real banger. I think I might have a Steph beating costume.
Wait. I might have one costume that I've been holding on to.
Oh, no.
Is it one that you made a reminder for?
I didn't have to because I've had it.
Got it.
For a while.
Anthony, this Steph beating costume that you speak of, is it something that we would instantly know, or where you have to go, this is the Steph beating costume?
No, it's a costume of me beating Steph.
Like physically?
Ow.
I'm gonna have a little Steph doll that I'm just gonna flick. No, I'm not gonna say.
No, it's fine.
You think it's a strong enough idea that it could be something that Steph would make? Look at her just sipping her tea. Unbothered.
I will not comment.
Delicious, but I was also listening to what he was going to say.
But I will say concept, and if I can pull it off the way that I am envisioning it, no matter what Steph has, I think I might have her beat that week.
A weapon to suppress Metal Gear.
Okay.
What Jordan said.
Something Metal Gear.
Something about Metal Gear. I don't know. I saw a couple Metal Gears at the the anime convention.
Nice. Oh, were they in a box?
Yeah, that's the only way I know.
Okay.
If I see a dude in fatigues and like walking around in a box, I'm like, that's a Metal Gear.
Why is solid snake?
Because you could use a box to hide in Metal Gear, and people think, oh, it's just a box. Yeah. I'm gonna walk past it.
Usually, if it's a walking box, it's like,
wait a second, this box isn't supposed to be here. And they check and they spot you, then you have to choke them out or shoot them, whatever, you know.
Yeah. Or if they hear the sound of his butt cheeks.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Sometimes his butt cheeks just be clapping too much.
Yeah, it's loud.
Be thick.
Ooh. Dummy thick.
Dummy thick.
I kind of really want to make a orc rogue who has zero stealth. It's like zero agility. He's just a very big lumbering
mess everything
orc.
Up.
Yes.
I mean, you could be a rogue and not depend on stealth.
Like a rogue that depends on intimidation over stealth.
Sure. Like, that's absolutely a thing.
Tries to sneak. Nope. I see you right there. They just, no, you don't. And then I don't see you.
I mean, roll a 20. Sure. Yeah. I'd allow it.
Exactly, Beck.
What's Beck say?
Can't repeat it.
Ah, damn it.
No. Oh!
You fool.
You got yourself. You played yourself.
Not how I thought this month was going to go. I think I'm still too tired. I'm high on ibuprofen.
Hit him with the Uno reverse.
He got me with the Uno reverse.
Oh, no. Let's see which one you get. Oof.
Stink bugger toasted marshmallow?
Oh, now it's
still got it.
Okay, I was like, could be on the floor now.
Yeah, I can't really tell with the red light.
Just flash your phone in front of it real quick.
Yeah, just put it in your mouth.
There you go.
Oh, it's peach.
Oh, peach no.
Fudge. It's rotten egg or it's buttered popcorn.
Well, I hope
I'm going to think positively that you have popcorn.
Yeah, I'm gonna hope that it's popcorn.
Thank you. I hope so too.
Survive.
It's all we can do.
It's a never, never survival.
It's buttered popcorn, but he's not happy with it.
I think the beer has coated his tongue so he can't taste it at all. Oh, there it is.
Oh, no, it hit. He got the wrong one. You malfunctioning makes my neck hurt.
Maybe shake the box up next time.
Yeah.
Shake. I haven't had like two colors in a row or anything.
Well, fair enough.
I know.
Shake.
It started like neutral, and I thought I knew it wasn't buttered popcorn, but it was still like kind of sweet because the candy shells always make everything a little sweet. And I thought, oh, did I get like a really weak barf?
Yeah.
And then it built and
oh,
and
that
caught
was
up with
barf.
Me.
That's what. Okay. Yeah.
Or barf or oh no, rotten egg. Rotten egg.
Oh, rotten egg.
It all tastes like barf.
Yeah, they're all not good.
They all taste bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
None of them is good, really.
Yeah. No.
We don't have much good flavors in here.
Oh. Golly.
I'm trying to think if there was anything else that like really stood out. No. I watched Knock at the Cabin.
How Batista Shamalamadingo.
Yeah, the M. Night Shyamalan.
How is that?
I would never recommend it.
So a Shyamalan movie.
Yeah.
I would never recommend it.
Actually, no. I would recommend The Visit. I would recommend The Visit.
Yeah, that one was really good.
I still haven't seen that one.
I think it's good. I think it's actually a good movie.
Did you watch that one, Leland?
No.
It's...
I know the twist, though.
Okay.
Yeah,
that one, that had me, there's a lot of unsettling parts. I was very bothered by, like, that situation.
Oh, bother.
But Knock at the Cabin, like, I started it, and I was like, okay, we'll see where this goes. And then I was just like, okay, I'm gonna just keep seeing where this goes. And then I watched it.
I'm gonna continue seeing where this goes.
Yeah.
But
I'm gonna see where this goes for 90 minutes.
Movie's over. Still waiting to see where this goes.
Still waiting for it.
Jordan pointed out M. Night Shyamalan doesn't know
dialogue.
Yeah.
Yep. He does not know what it sounds like for two human beings to speak to each other.
Yeah. And watching it is very much that. Like you're listening to
his biography.
Yeah. You're listening to the conversations and you're just kind of like, no one talks like this. Or if someone did talk like this that you're interacting with, you would feel a type of way. Like why are you talking like this?
Everyone talks like an NPC in a RPG, you know? Like they're talking at each other. Like not talking to each other.
Actually interaction? Like then really interacting? Yeah.
People are just like saying things to each other.
Saying things. I could see that a lot. Like, the conversation is just very, like, not fun. I mean, that would fit, Jet.
That would fit.
I didn't scream. I didn't really get scared. I was just more confused as, like, why this is happening.
Mm.
And then I realized the twist. And then I was like, okay.
What's a twist?
This is weird. That's all.
Was M. Night Shyamalan in the movie?
Yes.
Of course.
No.
He has one.
Was he actually in the movie or are you racist?
No. He's actually in the movie. Like, it's not a spoiler and it doesn't really mean anything, but he's on a TV ad.
Oh, okay.
The TV. Yeah. Like, he does talk. Because I think it's like an infomercial, and he's talking. And I was like, that's M. Night Shyamalan. And I was like, he's really in his own movie.
He loves to put himself in his own movies.
In his movie. Yeah. Well, that was it.
At least he's gotten better at not giving him, like,
the pivotal role.
Full role like he was for a while there.
Lady in the Water. He can only be solved by his character. Yeah. I hate that movie so much.
I remember we had a movie.
I kind of
want to
rewatch.
I will join you on this journey.
I will also join.
To see it again.
Just reaffirm my beliefs.
It's been so long. I just want to be like, let's watch it again. And see LoRC if it's different watch this party. Time. See if it comes across.
We'll watch all the Michael Jackson videos.
Steph, did you just say the S word?
Did I say the S word?
I think you said LoRC will watch S.
No, watch party.
I said watch party, but if you think I did say it, I might have. No. I don't know. It came out so naturally. I'm not sure. But yeah, chat, please confirm if I really did say it.
Somebody check the tapes.
Maybe I misheard it.
Flip the last 20 seconds and go back.
I know I said watch party.
I
heard
watch
party.
Okay.
I heard we're going to watch.
Which is something I would say. I would say that. So, like, okay.
Not giving him.
Yeah, we could do that.
The pivotal role.
Next movie, we'll watch it.
I don't know. Lady in the Water. I didn't hate it at the time.
Just reaffirm.
Let's watch.
But
it
I also just didn't care.
I will also join.
I hated the village at the time. Lady in the Water. I was just like.
I liked the village. The village was a weird twist that I wasn't expecting at all.
Oh, really? You didn't see that coming from the trailer?
Michael Jackson.
No, because I wasn't really watching those movies yet. Huh. I didn't dabble in this type of movies yet. So, I wouldn't know.
Oh, no, like, even from The Visit, I was like, oh, I know the twist. Like, sure. Just, the trailer was very obvious what it was.
I didn't see the trailer.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of, like, ways it could go.
That's true.
What, The Visit?
No, just in general with his movies, I feel sometimes the twist is the most obvious thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it though?
I mean,
I liked Unbreakable when I saw it. I liked because
Unbreakable and Sixth Sense they're undoubtedly his best movies, right?
Ooh,
yeah. Mm. I like Sixth Sense.
I like Signs. That's to me his top tier.
Also Signs.
Signs
but,
I watched later on. I was too afraid to watch that then.
Those first three? Yeah, his first three are where I think his strengths
are. It gets to the village and then it's a sharp, sharp decline.
Yeah.
Also,
Scott watched Unbreakable like last weekend for the first time because we want to watch Split and Glass.
I want to do that. I really want to do that.
I've watched Split. I have not seen Glass. Glass, I think I still need to watch.
Split is better. Split is the best of those three.
Would Split be considered a creepy movie that we could watch at Halloween, or is it more like an action?
It's more a thriller. It's more a thriller.
It's not a Halloween movie.
It's a psychological thriller.
Okay. Yeah.
Which is why it was such a treat when you find out the twist of that movie.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. We watched Them, the giant
ant movie.
Have you ever seen it?
No.
I've only done the mission in Fallout 3.
I mean, it was so good. Like, I looked it up. Like, it's considered like the quintessential first nuclear. Oh my god, we don't know what nuclear radiation could do to things. Movies from the 50s, and what I appreciated is like they don't. It's not campy. Like they treat it like they play it all straight. They're like, no, there are giant ants. Because of nuclear radiation. This is a thing we have to deal with now.
Like Godzilla.
It's treated kind of like in a Godzilla. Like, no, we can't. This isn't campy. There's literally a giant monster destroying Tokyo. We've seen proof.
Have you seen the new Godzilla trailer?
The trailer is wild.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have not.
Godzilla, I had a customer. I had a customer talking about it over the weekend. He was like, no, it looks good. I was like, all right.
A new American Godzilla?
No,
Japanese.
Making a new one.
Yeah,
right on.
It's a giant ant. It's clearly like a puppet. Like it looks like a puppet, but it's a good puppet. I was like, for 1954 or whatever. Like this is a really good puppet. And like some stuff happens along the way for a 50s movie that I was kind of generally like, oh man, they did that? Oh, okay. That's I was shocked.
Shocked.
That was really good. I was really impressed with it. I've only seen bits and pieces of it, so I was like really excited to watch it.
Right on.
I've always wanted to watch it just because of the one Fallout 3 quest that is just called them. You have to fight giant ants.
I mean, like, I was kind of really taken aback that at one point they were like, well, how are we gonna know the answer? He's like, look for an anthill. And I was like, oh yeah, I guess that's what you would do. I mean, either it's just a giant anthill, and they're like,
there's that mountain that recently just showed up out of nowhere.
I mean, yeah, like they just go into an anthill and stuff, and I was just like, and there was like flamethrowers, and they're destroying puppets. It's like, oh, you guys are just literally burning those puppets. That's not a special effect. It's like, yeah,
kill them with fire,
Nate.
Yeah, so I don't know. I like giant things attacking and eating people,
like eight-legged freaks.
Love it. Eight-legged freaks is. I enjoy that movie greatly. It's like, I know it's kind of not great, but yeah. And we watched another movie called Body Bags. It's a John Carpenter flick. He acts in it. He's not good. It's like an anthology, and he's the wraparound between the stories, and he's like this dead zombie kind of guy. He's doing like a Beetlejuice voice. Like, it's real weird. I didn't get it.
He's the mortician in Tales from the Hood.
It's stuff like that. But the last little movie in it was Mark Hamill was the star, and he played like a baseball player who's just about to hit it big, and you're like, this is like, I don't know, Scott will confirm, like late 80s, early 90s.
Okay.
There's no way he's...
This is Guyver Hamill.
Yeah, there's no way he's a baseball guy.
In his 20s?
And, yeah, I don't know if he was in his 20s. I mean, he definitely was playing an older baseball guy, but this did not work. I was just like, you should not be in this role. But he like loses his eye, and they put in another eye, and the eye is possessed by the guy who used to own the eye. It's body parts, but like, you know, it was interesting. A lot of choices were being made by Mark Hamill. And I was kind of like, when he started going crazy, I was like, oh, maybe we'll get a little Joker voice in it. No.
Never happens.
Just raspy Luke Skywalker.
So it's idle hands, but an eyeball.
Yeah, I think that was my biggest problem. I was like, this ain't a new story. Like, you've done this story a lot.
Yeah.
It's like the moment he got the eye, and I'm just like, all right, well, when's the monkey paw show up? Because
even when that came out, that was not a new concept.
No, not at all. But I don't know. It was fine. There were some enjoyable qualities about it. But point is, John Carpenter, not a good actor at all.
He should stick to directing.
I mean, I've seen some of his later movies. Maybe not.
You just stick to composing.
Yeah, there's a story my buddy Matt was telling. He told a story. Matt told me a story that John Carpenter, it was Rob Zombie told, that like he had to call John Carpenter to get his blessing before making Halloween. And I guess Carpenter on the phone was just like, one, who is this? And he was just like, I'm Rob Zombie. I'm a musician, director. He's like, right. Are you going to use my music? And they were like, yeah. He's just like, whatever. I expect a check.
Very pragmatic that way.
Yeah, he's just like, yeah. I don't really give a shit. I just want to play video games and collect money.
He's no Clive Barker.
No, he has no, that's why I respect John Carpenter. He's like, no, just give me a check.
I just made movies. Nothing's precious.
Yeah, just like. Anthony, you're about to fall asleep. You want to wrap this up?
Am I?
I mean, you just yawned like so long. I was
did
thinking
I?
Of you. I mean, yeah, you did like a huge yawn.
Okay.
I mean, it's up to you. I saw you pull out a box of cards. We can do a couple of those and then call it a night.
I was low on air. I just had to fill back up.
He's airing his mouth out from the bad flavors. All right, I get it.
Yeah, I'm trying to. My gut is already starting to like not
all
feeling
right, okay,
good
how
about
this. Did you pull out the Would You Rather cards? I saw you pulling something out.
I pulled out the hot take cards.
Which one is
where
that
we will have a question that we will answer for someone else on the podcast. So, for example, Jordan.
No, I said thank you for giving an example.
For Jordan, the three of us would answer, what is something he wouldn't do for $1 million?
Oh, that's a short. And I picked the best one.
It's a short list. Yeah, you can pick the best one.
Is that not how the game works?
The game works with people at a table.
So we have cards that say things on them. We would put them down.
No. You do have to make up something, but it just works smoother at a table.
Oh, okay.
We would be anonymous at a table, and he would pick whatever we wrote. That's not possible here.
Gotcha.
All right.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
So is that the first question?
Whatever is most truthful, sure. Whatever, Jordan, you feel is the most accurate is going to be the winner.
Okay.
Can you repeat the question?
What is something Jordan wouldn't do for $1 million?
Eat a fruit Tootsie Roll.
Ooh.
Steph coming in hot. Yeah, I can't beat that.
He was gonna kill the chocolate Tootsie Roll. He was gonna. What fruit Tootsie Roll? Or it was a Tootsie Roll for sure. And
the
if
chocolate
there was
ones are the ones he
two
hates.
Bullets, yeah. he would have shot the Tootsie Roll twice.
He's killing the worst
people.
All right, I want to say I don't think because I know Jordan well enough and I feel he's a good person. He would not kill a dog for $1 million.
It's a legit answer.
I don't think Jordan would quit video games for $1 million.
Oh man.
He looks at you like you're so wrong. But
okay, well Steph, you lose because it's the just normal chocolate ones that I don't like.
That's what it is. Okay.
Yeah, because the fruit
what
ones,
if it was the chocolate
bad
ones?
I wouldn't.
It's $1 million just to suffer for 30 seconds with a piece of chocolate flavored taffy.
Yeah, but I'll know.
I'll eat this whole bag for $1 million.
Yeah, no. Oh. I still eat the Tootsie Roll. Yeah.
Whole.
I deep throat it.
That's how you choke.
It's true.
I would sooner quit video games than kill a dog. So Leland wins.
Pick the
best answer, not like the one that is most horrifying if such a situation comes up again.
Okay, well, sorry. You always say play to the strengths, when that's why I lose. So I wanted to win this one.
You won. You won.
We all win. We all win. All right, next one for Steph.
But I want to win the most.
What is at the top of Steph's bucket list?
Oh,
go to Japan.
Get kicked in the chest by a horse.
Ooh, that's right.
Damn, y'all taking the good ones.
What did you just say?
Ooh.
Kendrick Lamar.
Got him. Nobody pray for him.
Buy a bucket hat in Japan. Pet all the otters. Oh, that's adorable.
No.
Can see her walking through like a gladiator style, but instead of the wheat he's touching, it's just otter faces coming up.
I'm gonna say swim with a pack of otters.
Oh, that'd be really fun.
No, that might be bad.
Or, not in her dreams.
No, Steph, you swim with them. They think you're one of them, and they take you into their tribe.
They make you their queen.
No matter what, that's a good bean.
Oh, was it like a blue one?
Yeah.
Oh.
Do they blueberry
blue,
or toothpaste?
Berry blue or toothpaste?
Or
yeah,
toothpaste.
Like, yeah.
It's berry
Which one
blue.
Is it?
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Whew.
Anthony, you never.
I really like the otters.
You're usually pretty good at this every year.
I'm usually better, but I am tired. My foot does hurt.
Fair enough.
My gosh, Scott, do I become hurts. Full otter?
You never go full otter, Steph.
No,
she, that's like her tusk.
That's her final form.
That's what I was referencing. I'm gonna go full otter. Just, you know.
All right, Steph, right. Which one do you think is the getting punched, being an otter, or go to Japan?
Oh, man. I mean, these are all good options. One, I would love to go to Japan. I would love to swim with the otters.
Top of your bucket list.
Steph, Jordan's will kill you.
I know.
Wolf, it's like a mini horse.
I forgot.
Sorry, I just envisioned that, and it was very humorous to me.
Just little Sebastian.
Little Sebastian.
Exactly. The horse isn't going to touch my chest. It's going to hit me in the shin, and I'm going to cry.
No, Steph will put it up on like a ramp.
We'll put it on a table.
Okay.
We'll get some apple boxes.
Scott also makes a point. If it kills her, the list is done.
True.
Yeah.
List complete.
Yeah. No more Steph's list.
It leaned forward. Also,
I want to swim with otters.
Yeah,
this is the top of your list.
That's $600. I already looked.
Is it?
And you swim
can be in
with
a jacuzzi
otters.
With otters.
A jacuzzi,
plural or just one? A jacuzzi.
Why is it a jacuzzi?
No, there's otters. It's like a, I don't know. It looks like a little jacuzzi pool or whatever, but.
Do they like warm water?
They love the jets.
Here, help me out. It's a jacuter.
A jacuter.
I think I paid $50 for that in TJ once.
Oh, no.
No,
yes!
You wouldn't.
Beth, nurtured by
that's
nature.
That's too expensive for you. You cheap.
I did.
You go down to the knockoff bar. You get the canuttered.
Jacuter is now a swear word. I looked it up. It's like 600 or 700.
But is it only one otter, or if you add another otter, is it another $600?
Several.
And then you're in a group of six, I think.
Like there's
only six
other
of
people?
You are in the pool. In the pool, and then these otters are around. And I think the whole experience is like 3 hours long.
Hmm. So it's like a swingers otter club.
That's an otter orgy.
So. Yeah. It's like it's right there near Hara's.
This one's for Leland. Uh-oh. What does Leland know more about than anyone else in the room?
James Bond.
That's
movies.
Well, I mean, between these three?
Generic room.
The names of every James Bond movie.
If you got some of Leland's friends in the room, there's definitely others that would be able to name more.
But they're not in the room.
Scott.
I saw it. I'm offended, but not wrong. But even though, no, I don't. I think Anthony would know more.
We just call it sex.
Is that like when Jordan corrected me about black magic?
Yes, it's just magic.
Is that what Leland would know more than
anyone else in a room?
In a room.
Yeah. I'm gonna say 80s pop music.
I mean, Scott puts me to shame.
An answer, but it's really lame, and I'm also wrong.
80s pop music, Bond, and gay sex. That's how
or
you all.
Comic
you
books.
See me.
Is it, it's the Leland starter pack.
it's You to a Kill. It's Madonna Lucky Star, and it's a leather harness.
Yeah, I don't know the terminology. Mine was like work related, I guess, or book related.
Comics?
Comic books?
Not necessarily comics. It's along the lines of like people who have their open orders in the store. Whatever
that
terminology
is. You're trying to get super detailed.
Well, that's what I was thinking. I was like, well, obviously.
Yeah, but that's less fun of an answer.
I know, but that was.
Yes, he knows the diamond shipment better than anyone else. He knows how to make an order with Penguin faster than anyone in the room. But those, that's not fun answers.
I mean, you're right, though.
Yeah.
Jordan, did you have an answer?
I said Bond. Bond movies.
Bond, that's
right. Yeah,
Bond
movies.
He could so name Steph, we'll every single Bond movie.
Steph will just
without a gun to his head.
Oh, I didn't know it was either that. I don't know. As soon as he said Madonna, I was like, he knows way more Madonna songs than I do.
True.
Mm-hmm. And then that's true. And then I started thinking, what's her name?
Beck.
Dolly Parton, or
yes.
Oh, Golden Girls. You know more Golden Girls stuff than I do, or anyone here, I think.
I mean, they're all acceptable answers.
But what's the best answer? What's your favorite answer?
Yeah. What was your answer, Steph?
Golden no, Girls? No.
You said like three different things, though.
Yeah, because I couldn't decide on which.
What was yours again, Anthony?
80s pop music.
Oh, yeah. I would go with Golden Girls because that's an enjoyable answer.
Okay. Yay!
The real answers were Star Trek was the good enjoyable. Answer in the chat. artistic shading. Yes.
I forgot
I know lots
what
of things
I was,
about artistic shading.
I forgot what I was talking about, but when me, Marco, and Roseanne were outside the U-Haul store, I think we were just talking about what was it? Like there was a convention. The Star Trek convention.
Okay.
When we were at Evo, was that what was going on when we were
yes.
at Evo?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. So yes. I was saying, yeah, there was like a Star Wars thing. And then he like, Marco looked at me and I was like, Star Wars, Star Trek, same thing. And he gave me the look and I was like, there's still stars in the front or whatever I said. Just one's a Trek and one's a war. I think, yeah, that's what I said.
She's got a point.
I mean, facts.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Ooh. Yeah. Okay. One's a trek and one's a war.
After the trek came the wars.
I mean, Scott said track over the weekend. And I about lost it.
Was he talking about Pharrell and the Neptunes?
Star Trek.
Oh, I haven't even.
He could have been.
I know that Neptune is a planet.
Also a Roman god?
Greek. Yes. Is Pharrell
yeah.
the one that
no,
wears
no,
the
it
hat?
Is Roman. Yeah, it's Roman.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, he wore the hat for a while.
Yeah. That's right. Oh, he doesn't wear the hat anymore.
He got the baby face.
It's all
face.
Just trends.
Oh. All right, last one, Anthony.
All right, for me... Mm-hmm. What would a movie about my life up to this point be titled?
Do you want us to go
mean?
No.
No, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, I had a joke ready to go, and then I realized that that's...
So everyone just coming up
with
mean-spirited jokes?
This is the first thing that came up.
It was not mean. It was just dark.
I was going to say sex, okay. drugs, and rock and roll, but I was like, no, you don't do drugs. So I stopped myself.
Oh, okay.
I haven't done drugs in a while.
I mean, Scott's is pretty good, though.
On top of spaghetti? Except it's a porn.
Spaghetti.
Didn't specify what kind of movie.
True. But it is a movie about my life. So if it's a porn, it does have to have a narrative.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I
Why?
Answered this
porn
wrong.
Porn doesn't have a narrative.
But it's a movie about my life. So this one does.
Oh, my yeah. bad.
Yeah. My first answer was totally wrong, but I'll say it anyways. As soon as you said movie, the first thing I thought of was, that's why he named you Joe Dirt, the Nutmaker. And I was like, Joe Dirt? And I was like, I'm not going to say that. It sounds rude. It has nothing to do with you. It's just more of you said movie. And I just thought Joe Dirt because your hair. Oh, your silence is so loud. I didn't mean to insult. I'm so sorry.
Your silence is so loud.
I'm not offended. I'm just really confused.
Me too. You said movie. I thought Joe Dirt. But then it was like about your life that has nothing to do with your life.
I said movie. And the first movie you thought of was Joe Dirt. We've talked about several movies tonight in the last hour and a half. We have mentioned easily 15 to 20 movies.
She's thinking your long ponytail in the back, maybe a mullet. Mullet. Yes. It has to be the hair.
There you go. Yeah.
Well, it's long in front and it's long in back.
And then he gets dreadlocks at the end of the movie.
And that's the name of your book.
Long in front and long in back.
The Anthony Silva the story.
The story about how I had my tail amputated. I kept the long in front part.
I'm going to say
Spooky's Big Adventure.
I want to say it'd be called Dark Gothic Spooky : and Fabulous.
It feels like an A&E murder biography title.
Whatever.
Oh, yeah, I didn't. Okay. So we have to name a title of your movie?
Yes. The movie about me. Again. What would a movie about my life?
Goth and Dangerous.
That's my lifetime movie.
Okay, fine. The Crow.
What would a movie about my life up to this point be titled, Stephanie?
The Jersey Devil.
I mean, Scott's winning right now.
Oh, man.
Yes, everything I own is black.
Final answer?
No, I don't know. The first one I think was the best one, but it's just mean. I don't want to make you mad, so...
Paranormal Activity.
Because of Victor?
Maybe that's why this blue light's not working. Victor only prefers the red color spectrum.
Scott said Paranormal Activity.
A little bit gothy.
Right, final answers, Jordan.
I'll stick with Goth and Dangerous.
Nice. Final answer, Leland. Final answer, Stephanie.
Goth and Nerdy.
Goth and Nerdy.
I got another dumb idea, but I don't think it's going to play out.
Just throw it out. This is your final answer. Just say it. This is your final answer.
It's like, it's Gothica.
Goth space thick space A? Is that what you think?
Hyphen A.
So it's Gothica, but Gothica.
It's Gothica with two C's.
There you go.
Got thicker than oatmeal.
I like it.
Joe Graveyard Dirt.
Listen, with the exception of chat, which beats all of you, Gothica is the best.
Yeah.
Yay!
In fact, now I have to go and see if Gothica is taken on social medias.
That could be your name in the game.
Oh my god.
Gothica. Do it.
Yeah, we'll see. All right. If you have enjoyed this ridiculous conversation, please be following us on our social medias. We are on the Facebook, Instagram, X, and Twitter. Nope, that's the same thing. Threads.
Yeah.
Facebook, Twitter, and Threads, and Instagram at LoRC Podcast, or by searching the League of Ridiculous Conversations. If you would like to catch more of this wackiness, every Tuesday this month, the month of September, is a No Swears episode. Like tonight, some of us are going to eat it hard and, what was that, four beans for me?
Four for you, three for Jordan, one for Steph.
Bad start for Jordan and myself. Yep. But we've got three more episodes to try and get Leland and Steph high up on that board. The game's not over yet.
Okay.
But Thursday is Co-op Thursday. That is a regular episode. If you like our old swearing selves, we'll be back there, as well as Sunday when it's Community Day, and we'll be playing games of large multiplayer varieties with those from our Discord.
For sure.
If you would like to be a part of that Discord, find the link in the chat. Join or reach out to us at any of those previously mentioned social medias to get in on that. It is a fantastic community of amazing people and constant content going on in all of our channels, which is numerous. This episode, if you happen to maybe miss the first half or anything, you want to catch up, becomes a podcast. Every following Monday, a new episode is released. So feel free to get that on any of the pod places. Stephanie.
Yes.
If the people want to find you on the internet, where do they find you?
You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch at Stephanoids. That's Stephuhnoids.
That sounds exactly like what I said earlier. I'm not hearing a difference.
When you talk like me, you make me sound like this.
When you that's talk how you like talk. Me, you make me sound like this.
Yeah. That's how you talk, like, Stephanie.
I don't sound like Mickey Mouse.
I don't sound like Mickey Mouse.
Stephuhnoids.
Donald Goofy.
Get back on this train. Leland.
Sup?
You can follow me on Instagram at Leland Pierce Art or Pineapple Pierce. I might have art coming. I'm working on it.
Sounds fun.
I looked back. I was a little disheartened. Like on the Procreate program, you can I save everything on there. So and I was looking back at the past years, in the last couple of years, it was just 67 drawings, 100 and something drawings. This year I've done 8. Like the whole year. I was just like, oh.
You're not
really
on a quota?
Yeah, but I don't know. It's just disappointing.
This isn't your job. This is your hobby.
Yeah, but if I'm not even doing my hobby, then something's wrong.
Ooh, yeah, we're working too much. The whole world's a dumpster fire.
You should draw us as spooky faces.
You know what? Yeah, do it. Spooky vases.
I can do vases. Steph, what do you mean faces? Like, you want me to turn you into
No,
like
no, no, vases.
Oh, like actual. I thought that was just
she meant vase?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I thought that was someone.
Like, have you got spooky urns or a vase or a goblet? Urn. Like, just something spooky.
Urn's just a vase for people. Like,
someone's an urn, someone's a goblet, you know?
Yeah, stuff like that. Like a spooky shelf. But we're on the spooky shelf.
Inanimate. Spooky items that we all are.
We're in Beauty and the Beast, but it's goth.
Which is also
Anthony's imagining it right now.
Anthony, what goth furniture what item would you wish to be?
Goth and the gorgeous.
I think Leland is like just a full hearth, just an entire fireplace.
Leland is the place holding us together.
Oh, yeah,
all of Leland.
A haunted dildo, as Beck says.
Shame on you.
It's just a dildo with a cloth over it.
You know exactly what it is because see the shape.
It's called a condom.
It's under the cloth.
But the condom is spooky.
It glows in the dark.
It just says one dot. Anyway, continue.
You mean the condom that what is it? Remember when you had that effect to make it like glow? There was like a glowing effect that you were doing on your is it like a
his penis?
On his OnlyFans.
No, on the dildo.
Sorry, wait, hang on, what?
I mean, use the glowing effect on the dildo, but remember when you were drawing, what was it? I don't know, space things?
Like, okay.
Well, there's a crack in a war.
No, no, I know what she's talking about. That effect where I make things shiny and glowy.
Yeah. Oh,
yes.
You use that effect on the condom. Yes.
But she started talking about OnlyFans halfway through that explanation, and it got weird real quick.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I was like, what? Because her exact words were on your OnlyFans. I was like,
no, I didn't say on your OnlyFans.
I said that. Oh, but okay, I used my Steph voice, so you couldn't tell the difference.
Oh, that's what happened. Here
okay,
we go.
Okay, so, Jordan, did you already say your stuff?
I did not.
Well, wait, Jordan, where can they reach you?
Oh, most social media platforms at Jordan Inzabear. The end. That's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anthony?
And if you want to see how gothica I can get, find me on Twitter and
how
Instagram
sick of this goth
and
can
threads
get.
At Spooky the 13th.
Nothing but squats.
Yeah.
It's instead of you texting you up, it's now you want to get gothic tonight.
Gothica. Yeah, that's gonna be my OnlyFans and Fansly. Find me OnlyFans / gothica.
That's two C's.
Two C's.
Mm-hmm. Two C's.
So until next week, I'm Gothica, and in alphabetical order, we are.
I'm Jordan.
I'm Leland.
I'm Steph.
Still alphabetical order.
Bye.
Next week. Bye.
Bye.
Are we doing nights?
No.
Okay. Bye,
no
everybody.
Nights.
Sorry,
bye.
Everybody. No night.
Thanks, tired. Thanks for staying out with us.
Y'all the best.
We'll see you on Discord.
Bye.
See you later.